Thinking about writing math, a love song. But I don't really love math. I mean, it's, you know, it's fun. But, like, sometimes you hate it, you know? Like, you hate it, but you love it. How about a love-hate song? I don't know if there is such a thing. I don't know if I could do that. All right, anyway, let's just get to work. All right, so today, guys, Mr. Shaw back again, working on solving exponential equations and growth and decay word problems. So we're going to see, I'll probably split this into two parts, and we will, let's just get going. All right, so the first, in this video, what we're going to talk about, like I said, is you're going to use the same base method to solve exponential equations, you're going to solve growth and decay equations, and then solve compound interest problems. Alright, so then a couple things you might need to know is the same base method and then compound interest. We'll talk about formulas for that and then the same base as well. So here is the same base method. So it says if my bases are the same and they have different exponents, then the exponents are the same as well. Again, these can only be equal if x equals y. So in this case, like I have 4 to the x equals 4 to the third, that means that x would equal 3. Okay, so what we have to do is we have to get them to be the same base and then set their exponents equal to each other and then solve. Okay, so let's get to it. I got a couple examples here for you. So first off, I've got 4 to the 2x equals 16. So the way you want to think about this is how can I rewrite 16 in order to be with a base of 4? Okay, well, I can rewrite 16 as 4 squared. So let's do that. So it'll be 4 to the 2x power equals 4 squared. So now here's the part that people always forget. Again, now you want to, what you want to do is you want to say, okay, you want to, I have the same bases, so now I'm going to set their exponents equal to each other. So it's going to be 2x equals 2 divided by 2, so x equals 1. And that's it. Okay. Now it won't always be that easy, but in this case it is. So in the next one, okay, so it says 5 to the x minus 3 power equals 125 to the x. So now, you won't always want to try to get the low, like get them in terms of the lowest one. Now they're not; it's not always going to be like that. We'll do those in a second. But again, how can I rewrite 125 in order to be a base 5? Well, 5 cubed is 125, so I can rewrite this guy as 5 cubed to the x. So now what we can do actually is we can move, whenever you have an outside exponent, you always multiply them. So here's how we're going to rewrite it. So it's going to be 5 to the x minus 3 power equals 5 to the 3x power. So now I have the same bases, so I'll go ahead and set them equal to each other. So it'll be x minus 3 equals 3x, and we'll solve it. So subtract x from both sides, negative 3 equals 2x, divide by 2, x equals negative 3 halves. And there you go. All right, let's keep going. All right, so now in this case, there's not a single way for me to rewrite 8 to rewrite 16 to be a power of 8. Because in this case, like 16 is like 8 squared is 64. And then like even 4s wouldn't work because 4 squared, there's nothing I can do with 4 in order to get 8. But these are both at their most basic, they're powers of 2. So in this case, I can rewrite 8 as 2 cubed equals 16 is going to be just 2 to the 4th power. So 2 to the 4th, okay, and then to the 3x minus 6. Again, if that's confusing to you, again, just think you're trying to get them in, trying to figure out what kind of bases you can use to change both of them into in order to get them to be the same base. And the answer there is 2. So in this case, again, I'm going to go ahead, I need to multiply. So I have a binomial in my exponent, so I'm going to have to distribute. So again, it's going to be 2 cubed equals 2 to the 12x minus 24. At this point in time, I could have set them equal to each other up here, but again, I just decided to distribute. It really doesn't matter. So now we can set them equal to each other. So it'll be 3 equals 12x minus 24. And solve. So add 24 over. So 12x equals 27 divided by 12. So x equals, this will reduce to 9/4, I believe, yep, 9 over 4. And there you go. All right, last one for the equations, and then we're going to get into the word problems. All right, so in this case, you see that I've got 1 over 9 and then 27 to the negative x. Okay, so this is one that's a little bit less intuitive. Okay, so we have to kind of think about this logically. So I'm going to focus just on the 9 and on the 27. The base I'm going to need there is 3. So what I can do is I can rewrite this. I'm going to rewrite this actually as 1 over 3 squared to the x plus 5 equals, now again, 27 to the negative x is the same thing as 1 over 27 to the x power. And then I can rewrite the 27 as 3 cubed. So I'm going to rewrite, go ahead and do that. So it'll be 1 over 3 cubed to the x power. So in this case, from here, again, I'm going to distribute. Again, 1 to any power is just 1, so I don't have to really worry about that. So then this is going to become 1 over 3 squared to the x plus 5, and you're going to have to distribute the 2. We'll do that in a second. And this will be 1 over 3 to the 3x power. So let's go ahead and distribute here. So this will be 1 over 3 to the 2x plus 10 equals 1 over 3 to the 3x. Now again, I could move these up to the top and make them negative. Again, there's no need to do that though, just because again, once we have this, now we have the same bases. The bases is of 1/3, and now we can just set them equal to each other. So it'll be 2x plus 10 equals 3x, and then just solve it. So subtract 2x here. So x equals 10. All right, so I'm going to try to get as much as I can done of the word problems in this video. So I've got about 8 minutes left, so let's get to it. So the first thing is that you're going to, when you talk about exponential growth, really exponential growth and decay can be modeled by the same equation, but what you're going to do is in exponential growth, you're going to see a plus in the middle here. So a sub 0 is going to mean the initial amount. R is going to be the percent of increase. Again, if you're talking about decay, it's going to be the percent of decrease as a decimal. Okay, so then in that case, like 15% would be written as 0.15. T will be the number of time periods, and then A is the total amount after T time periods. Okay, so again, it's pretty straightforward, and you guys will get used to it really fast. So let's go ahead and look at our first equation, our first problem. So it says in 2006, about 1 billion people used the internet. The number increased by about 19.5% annually. So write an exponential growth equation to model the situation. So again, you're going to write A. So A equals. So again, start with your initial amount. So this will be 1 billion. So 1 billion here. Okay, times. Again, it's always the 1. Again, I'll look back at the equation real fast. So it'll be 1 plus. Now again, the rate it says is 19.5%, so you want to write that as 0.195, and then to the t power is that last part there, okay? So to the t power here, just like that. Okay, so now it says about how many people will be using the internet in 2015. So the first thing is that I want to point out to you is that there between 2006 and 2015, that's going to be 9 years. Okay, so that is going to be my t value right there. So again, we're going to go ahead and just plug it in. So it'll be A equals 1 billion times 1. I'm going to actually go ahead and just add these together. 1 plus 0.195 is going to be 1.195 to the 9th power. All right, so now we can just grab our calculators out, okay, and do the rest of it really easily. Okay, so it's going to be 1.195 to the 9th. Okay, so we get that. Now what we're going to do is we're going to multiply by 1 billion. So times 1, okay, so 1,000 million billion. All right, so we've got, A will be about, and again, I'm going to go ahead and round up here, so it'll be 4,969,482,293. So 496,948. So 496,948. And then 2,293. All right. And again, it's 0.8, so I could actually just round up to 0.94. Let's go ahead and do that. Okay, so it'll be a, because it's asking us to be about, so let's say nine. So about 4,969,482,294 people are Snapchatting and Facebooking and doing things that nobody else cares about. Okay, there you go. All right, so let's keep going. Next one. So it says there are about 20 mice in your attic. Okay, that's gross. Okay, so here we go. Their population is growing exponentially at a rate of 30% per month. How many mice will there be in 2 years? Now, first thing, again, it's saying the rate is in terms of months. So I'm going to need my time in terms of months as well. So 2 years is 24 months. Okay, so let's be careful there. All right, so again, let's get to it. So again, it's gonna, the equation is just going to be A equals A sub 0 times 1 plus R to the T power. So A equals, the initial amount is 20. So times 1 plus, my rate is 30%, so 0.3 to the T power. Okay, so that's my initial equation. Again, it's asking me how many there will be in 2 years or 24 months, so I'll plug in 24 for T. So A equals 20 times, I'm going to go ahead and add this, so it'll be 1.3 to the 24th power. And let's get our calculators out. So 1.3 to the 24th is 542.8 times 20. So in 2 years, wow, this is disgusting. In 2 years, there will be 10,856.0, so I'm going to round down. So there will be 10,000, and I forgot it already. Okay, 10,856 mice in your attic. Gross. All right, let's keep going. Now I'm going to look at exponential decay. Again, you'll notice it's the exact same. I'm okay with you guys just instead of doing, you can write exponential growth slash decay and just do plus or minus and make sure you guys are saying, okay, for growth you add, for decay you subtract. Otherwise, it's the exact same. Okay, so let's go ahead and I'm going to go ahead and skip this. Again, it's the exact same, just minus instead of plus. All right, so let's get to an example. So it says the pressure of the Earth's atmosphere is 14.7 pounds per square inch at sea level. That pressure decreases by about 20% for each mile of altitude up to about 50 miles. All right. So it says write an equation to describe this situation. So it says that our starting point is 14.7. So it's going to be A equals 14.7. times 1, again, we're decreasing, so it's decay, so minus, the rate is 20%, so 0.2 to the T power. Again, this altitude up to about 50 miles is just, that is just filler, okay? You guys don't need to worry about that. So it says, what would be the atmospheric pressure 20 miles up? Okay, so again, you're going to take it, and you're going to plug in 20 for T. So 14.7 times 1 minus, actually I'll go ahead and, so let's go ahead and subtract them. So it'll be 1 minus 0.2 is 0.8 to the 20th power. All right, and we'll grab our calculators. So 0.8 to the 20th power equals 0.0115, and I'm going to multiply that by 14.7. So the pressure 20 miles up is going to be 0.169. Okay, I'll just say, that's fine. We'll just leave it like that. So it'll be 0.169 pounds per square inch. Make sure you guys label that as well. Okay? All right, so not going to get my other examples done in 20 seconds. So I will pick this up in the next video. See you guys then.